This Civic Media podcast is sponsored by UW Organ and Tissue Donation. Organ donations are desperately needed, and now is the right time to become an organ donor. Talk to your family. Get the dot. Save lives. Go to heroicdeed.com.
Coming to Northeast Wisconsin live from the Civic Media Studios and featuring TV and radio broadcast veteran John Mino, along with the City of Green Bay's longest serving mayor, Jim Schmidt. This is Mino and the Mayor. Here are your hosts, John Mino and Jim Schmidt.
Hey, thank you very much. Always great having Mark Houston in the house. And, of course, Frank from Frank's Dinner. Oh, yeah. Sit. Frank's. I always
Let
say it wrong.
Let me be Frank Productions.
Let me be Frank Productions. Right. I can't believe I still get that wrong. Joining us right now, it is time for Burkle's One Block Over Green Bay Packer Football Throwback. And now, ladies and gentlemen, the pride of St. Charles, Illinois. The rangy right-hander who matriculated at the University of Notre Dame. The Golden Dome before leaving because Dan Devine kind of sucked. And came to the University of Wisconsin where it led the Badgers to gridiron glory. Ladies and gentlemen, joining us right now, number 16, Randy Wright. Randall.
All right, Randy.
Good morning, guys.
Wow, you sound excited.
There you go.
I give you a beautiful intro, and that's where we get, Randy.
I was going to say, man, who does your writing? That was pretty outstanding.
There's no writing here.
Believe me, Randy, there's no writing here.
That's a gift from God.
Right. Hey, well, you know what? You and I are great friends. We've been great friends for a lot of years. I never asked you about Notre Dame, because every Catholic kid growing up wanted to go to Notre Dame,
especially in Illinois.
Exactly, absolutely. What was that like? You just didn't like it, huh?
Well, I mean, given the fact that when you're a quarterback in Catholic and Notre Dame offers you a scholarship, you just kind of go,
right?
And you never question. But even though I went to high school as a junior and senior in St. Charles, Illinois, I was born and raised in Texas 16 years,
right?
And back in that day, the only thing you really knew about Midwest football was Michigan and Ohio State. They dominated everything. And Notre Dame. So given the chance, Ohio State never recruited me. But Michigan was a very, very close second. But when Notre Dame offered, like I said, Catholic quarterback, Notre Dame, you don't really think about it. You just kind of go.
If my growth plates had closed, we were talking about this earlier, I could have been there at Notre Dame.
You know, yeah, except for the fact that you aren't. And,
right.
You know, when you look at the fact that your growth plate must have closed really early in your
really
life.
Early, yes.
Okay, thanks, Randy. Wow. So we are with the mayor and we're with Dennis from the Glam Band.
So, Randy, tell me, I just want to talk a little bit about Notre Dame because I think it's just not Illinois people. I mean, I tried to get into Notre Dame.
Oh,
I think
gosh,
it did to everybody. And there was a lot of Catholics
dream.
In this part of the world.
Terry Handratty was my hero. Remember Terry Handratty,
no,
Randy?
Absolutely.
Yep.
Did your parents drive that decision? Because my dad was like, you know, St. Thomas, St. Norbert, Marquette. You know, that's like...
Anything with Saint.
Yeah, well, it just wasn't... You know, I think back when I went to school, the parties were too tempting for me. Although they were at these other schools, he just didn't realize it. You know what I mean?
You were a partier?
Anyway, go ahead, Randy.
Yeah.
Did your parents pick that for you?
You know, my parents certainly drove my religious Catholic background.
Yeah.
But they were very hands-off, and maybe hands-off is the wrong term. They did not put any pressure on me when it came to college choices.
Nice.
I knew that they wanted to be able to drive to the game, so they preferred that it be somewhere close by so they could do that instead of going to Texas or USC or someplace like that. But no, they
nice.
Did a fabulous job instilling in me the Catholic faith and the tradition, but no, they did not
All right,
necessarily.
Cool.
I think they were happy that I went there, but
yes.
No, they didn't drive that.
So, Randy, how does a guy go from Texas to Illinois? And you know, I guess you're saying about age 16. How do you get noticed at that point? Because it's kind of like almost kind of late in the
Great
game
point,
already.
Yeah. Especially nowadays.
You know, nowadays it's late, but you know, in there, I went to high school as a freshman in Texas, because that's where I was born and lived the first 16 years of my life. But then I transferred with my family. My dad got moved to Boston area, So I went to high school as a sophomore out in Boston.
Jeez.
And then got transferred again and came in as a junior and senior to the St. Charles area. And out there, in recruiting was a much later process. You really didn't start getting recruited till your junior year.
I remember
and then you go through your senior year, and then it's a huge push the second half of your senior season through signing date, I think was February at some point back then. So today, I think it's a lot harder for late bloomers to be recruited because it happened so much earlier. But back then, everybody was a late bloomer when it comes to that.
Hey, Randy, talking about Wisconsin football and the NIL thing. So, you know, we have one of our great friends here, Tony Bennett, who I hold in the highest esteem as a human being, as a person. And I talked to his dad about a month ago, and he actually gave me the heads up. He said, I think Tony's getting out of the business because this whole NIL and the college thing. What's going on out there, buddy? I mean, you've dealt with it because you coach and everything. What's going on in the world of college football these days?
Well, it's certainly a different landscape, isn't it? And I think although some of the changes can be exciting, the playoff system, a lot of that stuff, the NIL, I am not a fan of as it exists today. I think it's contributing greatly to the demise of college sports, but especially college football, because there are so many other athletes that are in the NIL that are not just in football. But from the is it good for college? I don't think so. Is it more fair to the athletes? Yeah, absolutely, it's more fair. I think if they make two adjustments, I would be a much bigger fan. Two changes I would make if I were king for the day, and I'm probably a very small minority that would agree with this. But number one, I think they ought to put all the money that goes to a kid in a trust fund, and he gets it when he gets his degree. So you could pay this player $1 million a year, but it goes into a trust, and he gets it when he gets his degree. And then if I leave early to go into sports, I don't get it. Well, if you're leaving early to go pro, you don't need it. No. So that would be the first change I'd make. The second change I would make is any player that leaves that school, any NIL money he earned at that school goes back to the school. So he doesn't get to keep that money and go. And that would stop a tremendous amount of this transferring every year and still being able to play. So,
now, that's a great idea.
That's a great idea.
That, and I just want to say, Randy, people just aren't ready for that kind of money at that young age. I don't sound like an old guy, but I mean, you're right. Even that few years could give you a little bit more time to maybe talk to people, study it, meet with a financial planner. But boy,
sure,
to blow through that money, that NIL, I think that would help with the coaching because they want to retain these people and they're just moving
absolutely
from place to place. That's a really good idea. Has that been talked about, proposed? I mean, I don't really follow it as close as, like John.
No, I mean, but there's nothing to – it's so bizarre. It's so new landscape that none of us have a handle. I mean,
there's no guardrails on it.
There's nothing, right, Randy? I mean, that's just – why it's the Wild West.
It is absolutely the Wild West. And when you put that in conjunction with kids can transfer now and not have to sit out, I mean, why wouldn't these young kids just sell themselves every year to the highest paying school?
And they are.
And I think, exactly. I think a lot of them are doing just that.
Right.
There's a kid from Nina who he's 3 years into college basketball, really good basketball player, three different schools. He's gone to a different school every year. Isn't that crazy?
Yeah, and this would stop that. I don't know how he's doing it. But
one of those credits transfer.
That's the issue. The credits don't transfer, so I don't know which kid you're talking about, but I'm sure he hasn't had all of his transferred credits counted at the new school he's going to, and he probably doesn't care in the
exactly
fact that he's making this kind of money. And how many stories, how many times, how many teammates did I have who, if you look at throughout the NFL, which is just from my perspective the only inside information I would have, I mean, these kids are 22, 24, 25 and can't handle the millions of dollars given to them. I mean, how are 19, 20-year-olds making that kind of decision? And the pressure you put on these 19, 20-year-olds who may feel they need to help their family out, I think there's a better way than it is right now, that's for sure.
We're with Randy Wright, former Green Bay Packer and Wisconsin Badger quarterback.
Randy, got two quick things. Deion Sanders' kid, quarterback at Colorado, filed for bankruptcy. Are you freaking kidding me?
Well, that's his brother who did. It's not the quarterback.
It's his son. Oh, the defensive back?
He was the defensive back. Yeah, but it's not the starting quarterback now, because I thought that too.
Oh, I'm sorry about that. And the UNLV quarterback who was given a handshake deal didn't get what he was promised, and he quits. You know, I mean, that just drives me crazy. But also, I just thinking about what you were saying too about what to do with the money. I think if a guy quits school and goes to another school, the NIL money should be distributed to guys like, say, the offensive linemen or some guys are trying to earn us walk-on guys or something like that, something to help them get by. Something like that might be a great idea.
I think it ought to go back to the school 100%. Whatever the school chooses to do with it, your suggestion, another idea, I'm in favor of. But that athlete shouldn't be able to keep that money.
Agreed.
That he takes with him that he earned at that school. Most of that money is probably coming from alum or coming from advertisements that he's done for businesses in that community. And you're taking it away. And I think one of the reasons you don't have the loyal fan base at the NFL level that you used to have is because teams, you lose free agency and good players leave and they go to other teams. And from the NFL perspective, there's a little bit less the fan loyalty because I'm pulling for Tom Brady. Now all of a sudden he's playing down in Tampa.
Exactly.
And I think that is absolutely what's going to happen to the college level with Deion Sanders goes into Colorado and replaces 86 football players in 1 year.
Yeah.
I mean, that's kind of, I think that's wrong. So I think there are a lot of things that are wrong with the NIL. I think the players deserve to be compensated. They deserve to be paid if the universities are making that much money off of them. No problem. In addition to the scholarship, no question. But I think it's wrong the way it is right now, and I think a lot of your good coaches, Nick Saban, Tony Bennett, I think you're seeing a lot of them that are going to get out.
No question.
Man, they've got Price a pop. Yeah, I mean, you're worried about the players, but when it starts affecting your fan base, I mean, it's like, come on, you
guys.
Well,
Jim and I were at a banquet of a year or so ago, and Mark Murphy, Packers president, had been an athletic director. He said, I can't think of a worse job right now in sports than being an athletic director in college.
Like in front of 1,000 people.
Yeah.
He just got up and said that.
Point blank.
And it's coming true because then Bennett's Absolutely. Left since then, Saban. And yeah, I hope this gets turned around. Is there, like, have you seen, I mean, you're obviously well-credentialed. Are you on some committee to work on this? Because I know there's a lot of talk about it. And sometimes you got to get in a room and what's the venue for this to fix it?
Well, I think like a lot of things, it has to hit rock bottom terrible that it's forcing a change.
Yeah.
And I think Ryan Day came out last year at one point at Ohio State going into the off season, and he was under a lot of pressure, having lost to Michigan 3 years in a row, still is under pressure like every head coach at OSU. But he came out last year and said he needs $13 million in his NIL fund just to keep the kids that are on his team right now.
13
not any transfers,
million.
But 13 million just to keep the kids that are on his team right now.
Randy, we got to start a quick break. Randy Wright joining us. Back right after this.
You're listening to Civic Media. You can tune into any of our live shows on any radio station across the state with the Civic Media app. Find us in your phone's app store and listen anytime, anywhere.
Hey, welcome back. Mino the Mayor here along with Dennis, of course, from the Glam Band. We got Young Sage for our Heights Pub and Portland Music Series. This, of course, our Packer Throwback Friday, brought to you by Burkle's One Block Over. And I got to give Kevin, I don't know if he's even back yet, I give him all the credit in the world. He went down to North Carolina and Florida and loaded up semi-trucks of stuff.
And hasn't come back.
And was boots on the ground. Yeah. God bless him.
Amen.
Yeah. Yep.
Yeah, we talked to him, and he's down there and just
right there, man,
giving it all.
Burkle's One Block Over, bringing us this very special segment. Randy Wright joining us right now. Okay, Randy, we're switching gears. Let's talk a little bit about what's going on with the Green Bay Football Packers. What do you think?
Well, I think they're facing a tough schedule with their division. Tough loss last weekend, but to probably the best team in the NFC, in my opinion. Detroit is playing so well. But I think there's a lot of good days ahead for the Packers. They're such a good young team, and I'm excited for what they can do the rest of this year. But certainly for their future the next couple of years.
It's different though, right? Kind of being not, well, I don't know if the right word is intimidated, but I mean, the Lions, we used to just run that division and didn't even worry. It's like, well, that's a win. And when the Lions came
they
in here.
They did it the old fashioned way. The Lions have done it the old fashioned
way. Have.
Drafting and everything.
Right. So they're tough.
Yeah.
No, they imposed their will on the Packers.
Yeah. They're really good. And they've done it, you know. They've done it through the draft, like you guys have said. They've got some players they've gone out and traded for. Jared Goff is playing just, I don't want to say above himself, because he's, you know, I think he was the number one pick in the draft when he came out, but he's certainly playing up to that at this point. But they've been playing without arguably their best defensive player, Hutchinson, being out.
And don't you kind of, isn't there like part of us is maybe Midwest nice, but don't you like seeing that old lady who owns the team? You know,
oh, Mrs. Ford.
Yeah. Mrs. Ford. And then like Mrs. Hunt, you know, before she died. You know,
sure. Or Mrs. Hallis.
Right, Mrs. Hallis. Yeah. They sit up there with their, you know, their pearls and stuff. And I'm like, well, that's cool, lady. You know, I just love seeing her. So anyway.
But, you know, I think everybody kind of deep down, maybe not everybody, but a lot of people have seen a lot of the struggles for Detroit for many, many, many right. years. And there's a part that says, you know what, good for Coach Campbell, good for what they're doing. I pull for them. I like Jared Goff. I pull for him. Not last week when they played Green Bay, but
right.
I think good teams get rewarded when they do it the right way. And I think you're seeing that with Detroit right now.
And we all love grandma.
Absolutely. How can you not?
It's just taking a long time for them to reshuffle the deck, though. I mean, yeah. to get the, and it starts from the top down. And so I'm glad they finally got some good people. I mean, I'm not a Lions fan by any means, but I hate to see a team getting kicked around for 34
I got,
years.
Hey, Randy,
you know?
I got to tell you something. I have no idea why, but something just popped in my head. I remember a very tough situation you were put in Detroit at the Silver Dome when Lynn Dickey got hit in the eye or something, and you had to come in against that defense. Remember that?
Yeah, that was Thanksgiving. That was, I think, my rookie year against Thanksgiving. I do remember that. And we came back to a degree, but still wound up losing the game. And I think that was the only game we lost the second half of that season. But, it's always been a tougher place to play when you're playing them there versus in your own stadium. But I think they have been able to do a lot of things to turn it around. And, Jimmy, you'd mentioned, you know, the last 35 years they've really struggled. And that's a little bit of the NFL free agency now. You can go out and sign these players. You don't have to build it the way you did 20 years ago, 30 years ago. And I think that helps teams like Detroit be able to turn things around relatively quickly.
Randy, let me ask you this. And obviously, I was, you know, I said literally every practice for like 5 years, every single game, every whatever. And I saw things, you know, on the ground level. What would it have taken for those teams that you were on, 85, 86, 87? What would it have taken to be a better team, more of a contender?
You know, in talking to NFL personnel people, more when I was involved, and even Green Bay's personnel people when I was there, but even since then, almost to a T, they will tell you, if there are 50 players on a team, and let's just say that that's what all 50 players, all 50 teams have, the difference between all of them are your top five and your bottom five. If you have the top five players are better than the other team's top five and your last five players are better than the other team's five, you can interchange the 40 in the middle with any team in the NFL, and it's the top five and bottom five. They're going to make a difference.
Wow, that's a great –
that makes
that.
A lot of sense. That's,
I've never heard
a little that. Of that 80-20, but yeah, that's – I like that.
It's almost like a business thing, right?
Yeah, what is? It's yeah, that makes a lot of sense.
It's not like saying the last, you know, games are separated by six or seven plays.
Right.
You know,
right.
It's kind of a similar mindset.
Yeah.
Brilliant.
Yeah. Well, you look at the Chiefs, who probably are the predominant team in the NFL right now, and you take their top five players and you put them on one of the worst teams, and you take their bottom five players, who are probably better than the middle five in other teams.
Right.
You take their bottom five, and yeah, that's going to be your 80-20 rule. But that's what people who have much more knowledge than I do have shared with me, and I think that makes a lot of sense.
It does.
So to answer your question, John, yeah, you exchange the top five and the bottom five, and you got a whole new team.
Wow, that's a great point.
So I think the Packers now, I think the bottom five, are probably as good as anybody in the league, but the top five, on the other hand, to use that comparison, probably a little bit lacking at this point.
Yeah. Well, defense, we need a pass rusher.
And it doesn't take a lot of great players. Like, I mean, obviously Jordan Love has proved himself and earned where he's at. But it doesn't take, you know, I hate to say a Lawrence Taylor, because there aren't any other Lawrence Taylors other than him. But you get a great pass rusher. You get a shutdown corner. You get a strong left tackle. You get a game-breaking wide receiver. You get a star quarterback. And, boy, they sure make a lot of other people better.
Hey, Randy, you know one thing, too, and we're going to be wrapping it up here, but there were some kids, oh, my gosh, I'm still 90 years, but some of these young players that would come in, and they had physical attributes, whether it was, and we're talking about this, is it a gene pool, is it a chromosome, right. But they had so much, and they didn't put it together. And I'm going to throw out a name, and you might laugh, but like Brent Fulwood or Frankie Neal or whatever, these guys had the physical God-given gifts, and they couldn't put the rest of it together. Isn't that frustrating when you see that?
Well, it's frustrating, and you feel for the player, the person, more than the player, because they do have this ability. They do have, you know, most of it's God-given, and they work hard. But, you know, we just talked about the five top rule, the five bottom rule. You take those other 40, and the reason those 40 are in the NFL are all the intangibles. It's, you know, what's kept them there. There were, you know, somebody asked me the other day, and I'll share this in doing an interview that I did. You know, when I was in Green Bay, there were 17, 18 quarterbacks that came and left during my career there.
Wow.
So I was there, and there were 17, 18 that came in. And people have asked me about X and Y. You know, if you take 700 players, I may have been better than 675 of them. But the other 25, I just got the breaks at the right time. I just got the opportunity at the right time. You could have exchanged me with 25 other quarterbacks during that era, and they would have gotten the breaks, and they would have been there.
Wow. If I was, Randy, if I was 6'3", do you think I would have been in the NFL, yes or no?
All right, there you go, Randy.
Let him answer.
Good answer. He did.
All right. Randy Wright, you're the best.
Thank
great
you,
having
Randy.
You on, my friend.
You bet, guys. Thanks for having me
Thanks.
On.
Thanks.
You're an organ donor, right? Well, here's a tragic fact. Approximately 20 people die each day waiting for precious donated organs. You could make a life-saving decision simply by getting that important dot on your driver's license. That little dot shows those who need to know that you've made a decision to donate organs at a critical time. Go to heroicdeed.com to learn more about the importance of organ donation and how you can make your wishes known. Talk to your family. Get the dot. Save lives. HeroicDeed.com.
Take Mino and the Mayor with you anywhere. Download the Civic Media app today from the Apple Store or Google Play Store. And text the studio directly, all from the Civic Media app. Download it today. Now, once again, here's Mino and the Mayor, John Mino and Jim Schmidt.
Hey, thank you very much. Welcome back. Mino and the Mayor here on a beautiful Friday morning, 97.9 FM, WGBW, 98.3 FM, WISS, and Oshkosh. And of course, worldwide.
And of course, world.
Civic Media.
Sorry, that was me.
App. Who was that?
All right.
Todd?
That was your ghost.
Do you mind?
There it is.
Yeah, I'm trying to do something here.
Well, let me jump in here.
It's like brought to you by Heights
All
Pub
right,
and Parlor.
All right, as fall settles in, check out our friends at Heights Pub and Parlor, 217 Washington Street, downtown Green Bay, for warm atmosphere, excellent service, and top-notch food. Enjoy superb lunch and dinner, savoring in our signature panini, prime Angus beef burgers. Enjoy cold beverages, cocktails, happy hour specials, Monday through Thursday, 2 to 6. Even join them for happy hour specials during the Badger football games and the Packer game. No Packer game this weekend, but you still come down there. They still got all the great food and all the great drinks. Their second store parlor offers the best space for hosting private party events. For more information, go to Facebook at Heights Pub and Parlor or online at www.heightsgb.com.
All right, and Ashley is here. Hey, Ashley.
Hey, how's it going?
You know what? I got to be honest with you. I've got that same pullover that you gave me.
Yeah.
I get a lot of compliments. People are like, where is this? What is this place?
Ooh.
That's a cool pullover.
It is.
I like
Isn't it,
though? It.
Aren't they?
Love it.
Yeah. Hey, what do you got it. Going on?
Well, it's Friday. So tonight, the Meyer Theater has Always Loretta, a country tribute to legendary Loretta Lynn, starting at 7:30. So come stop in at Heights and enjoy a perch plate, beer battered walleye, or pan fried walleye before the show. Maybe grab some drinks.
Nice.
And we just tell our waiter or waitress, I got to go to the show, and you guys like speed it up.
Hurry up.
Yes.
That's awesome.
I mean, you know.
Okay, I have to say one thing.
Depending on what time you show up.
I just want to warn people on one thing. If Heather's working, don't give her a hard time because it'll come back at you.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, you're right.
Well, you thought I'd be waiting up when you came home last night.
Loretta Lynn.
Ashley, come on.
Ashley, that's.
I think I'm a little young for that.
Do you want the name of the song?
Wow.
Don't come home a drinking with loving on your mind.
Oh, boy.
So basically, it is.
Isn't that awesome?
It is.
Classic.
Oh, that's awesome.
It's right up there with Sage's music. So, all right, well, here, let's go.
Dennis, introduce our special guest.
I'm still still hung up on the warm atmosphere part of the ad. It's the time of year where we're looking for warm atmosphere.
Yeah. Exactly.
Thank you for that invitation for warm atmosphere, because I'm looking for that
with
right
fall
now.
Fall settling in.
We
okay,
all should
what's,
be.
Okay, can I ask a question about, because I bring this up to you, and I don't mean to sound in a strange way or whatever. Musicians in my era just pretty much ate or drank or did whatever. You, kind of like a bodybuilder type guy. Check out the guns on this guy. Yeah. Oh, my God.
Gun show. Right.
Wow.
Not that big, don't you?
Well, I don't know, man. It's
you're bringing the noise.
It's noticeable.
And
if somebody said, hey, we're bringing the Packers strong safety into our
game. I played football.
You did play football? Yeah, I believe
4 years now. Right now, I played for the Raiders. Last year, I played for...
Wait, you played for the Raiders?
No.
You played in the NFL?
No, semi-pro. Okay. I was like, I wish. If I'm not a Cowboys fan, my uncle will break my legs. So, Raiders, no. 2 years ago, I played for the Sabercats. Last year, I played for the Ravens. And this year, I played for the Raiders.
Right. Wow. Okay.
But you got to admit, you're pretty well built, and don't say you're trying. Okay. If you really wanted to hide it, you would have worn something like a fleece, but you're wearing like a tank top.
No, it's not a t-shirt.
He brought his own warm atmosphere.
You know?
Oh, yeah, he's showing. Ashley is just going, oh my God. Yeah, I love your body.
He's showing off a little bit.
I just right, Ashley? The first shirt I just
bought. I didn't see anything.
Is your husband listening?
Yeah.
Oh, no.
Okay, good.
In studio, we're talking about young Sage.
How about getting off his lap? Okay.
Oh, you better watch it, Mike.
Wow.
We're in studio with Young Sage this morning, ladies and gentlemen, and guns and everything you brought with him today. Right. And let's get to know him a little bit. So we were talking before you walked in here that you're from Texas originally. Mm-hmm. What was your upbringing like, and how did you get here? What brought you here?
Man, long story. But long story short, so we grew up, very poor where I came from. It's just been me and my mom. My dad... was really not there, but I have 13 uncles and aunties, and all of my uncles pretty much raised me. I have 6 uncles. They all passed away, unfortunately, but basically how I started my career is I used to sing, I used to dance, I used to try to rap. it was pretty bad. But I always promised them that I use my talent for God, and two, to get rich one day and make sure that my family got out of the situation we were in pretty much. So since I made that promise, I have been pursuing my music career ever since pretty much.
How'd you get here?
That's
what
awesome.
Brought you here?
So my
car?
Uncle, pretty much. No, the train actually.
Right.
My Uncle Lee, he actually lived here, and my mom wanted to see more family. And my Uncle Lee and my Uncle Bay are the last ones that are left, and they stay here.
I got you.
So we were like, let's go see some new family, whatever. Right. And then we came down here when I was like 13, 14, something like that.
There's a song in there somewhere.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, there is. I think it's actually Better Days. Yeah, Better Days by me. I kind of talk about, my upbringing a little bit.
And folks, I'm excited about bringing him in here because I was listening to his music, and my goodness, this guy's got a voice on him. And it's exciting that he's using the elements of music, adding a voice to it. And I think the genre, I think on a large part, is missing that musical aspect of it. Mm-hmm. And I want to give you all the credit in the world for that. And I think and you really, in my book, you should be huge. You should be worldwide right now. So let's do what
coming
we can
from him. That's very, very high praise.
Sincerely, man, this guy is amazing, and you really should check out his music. Before we get into into listening to some of that, how do we get in touch with you, your and whatnot?
So anywhere you can have internet, just look up Young Sage.
And
you're fine. Yeah, it's actually pretty cool. My first time I figured out you could Google me, I was like, what? And my name popped up, all my stuff, my Instagram, my Snapchat, my TikTok. I was like, oh, okay, I'm on the interwebs. Cool. Love that.
Back in the day when we Googled something, we'd go to jail. The word Google meant something completely different. Hey, I'm just saying.
I think that was before my time.
You've got your acting certificate. Ask him about what he has.
I was actor of the year at Mesabi State Junior College.
Right.
Oh. How about you?
I have a Guinness World Record.
What?
Serious?
Yeah. Sure got quiet around here. What do you mean?
So my biggest thing I figured out was my niche was music competitions. I started them when I was like 18, 19. We used to go to Chicago, and they used to have these little competitions that they do. So I entered, and I was like, okay, let me see if I'm good at it. And I won. And so I'm like, okay, let me come back. I went 9 times at the Chicago and won every single time. To Whoa, where they told awesome. Me, like, you're going to have to become a special guest because you can't keep winning. So now I'm like, okay, this is my niche. So then I went all around the world traveling, doing competitions, and I ended up setting a Guinness World Record in 2022 for winning over 2,200 music competitions.
And that's
And that's the most in, like, history. I've beaten 2,200 people in music competitions.
Okay, I got to tell you something. We're amongst royalty.
I was going to say the same thing.
This man right here is Vocalist of the Year for the state of Wisconsin. Awesome. This guy right here, his dad and his uncles were on the Ed Sullivan Show, Lawrence Welk. They were worldwide known for Barbershop Quartet. Oh. I'm a pretty good singer. Ashley's got
nothing. She's a pretty good singer.
I got nothing?
You should hear him.
Can you sing?
Bit. Nope,
let me hear.
Nope.
Let me hear a little something.
Church choir.
How do you? Okay, we had this discussion regarding sports and stuff, and we had Frank here from Frank's Dinner Theater, who's hugely popular. Is it in the genes if somebody can sing? Is it passed on?
It can be. Okay. So I don't know if you know who Mo 3 is. He's a music artist from Texas. He's actually kind of big. He's my uncle. Okay. He's the one who passed away in Texas. So he's also a reason that I, like, really want to start my career, because I feel like I have very big shoes to fill, pretty much. Not a lot of people know that he's, like, my blood, you know? So, like, a lot of stuff going on back home, so my mom tells me, you know, refrain from telling a lot of people. But it means a lot to me because, like, it's my family, and he was huge, you know? So, like...
Well, I would leverage that Guinness Book World Records, man. I mean, that's cool in and of itself, you know? Right. We had a guy that... was on our show all the time, and then John asked him one time, we were in school, athlete. The guy ran under a 4-minute mile.
Yeah.
Like, that stuff just doesn't happen. And like you, that just doesn't happen. And I'm interested. I can't wait to hear you sing, although I read a little bit about you, but I haven't heard you sing yet. So that's pretty cool. And to Dennis's question, like, you seem like you're right on the cusp of being big.
Should be monstrous.
My biggest thing is, like, one, like, I really noticed, like, you know, in Wisconsin, it's kind of hard to get yourself out there when it comes to music, because everybody wants to do music, you know? So when you tell people, hey, I do music, then they're like, eh, okay. Until they hear you, then they're like, oh, you're actually good. And I'm like, yeah, I tried to tell you.
Okay, a couple things on that. One is that we are really trying to promote more music, right? Mm-hmm. Mile of Music, some things that we're doing here. And we have a lot of venues for music too now, right? We got Tarleton, which is kind of a smaller...
200. I did a show there.
Okay. And you can move up then. Meyer Theater, the Widener, you know, the Rush.
I went to Summerfest. Summerfest actually asked me to perform last year. This year. Yeah. And they paid me $5,000 to perform. I was like, okay.
Oh, that's awesome.
Well,
wow.
I'm not worthy. Gee, $5,000. $5,000
for one show?
Yeah. Nice. I got the emails and everything. It was actually really cool. And they want me at Rolling Loud next year because the performance was, like, so good. And I was like, cool.
Maybe
you got to talk to him, Mino, about going in on the business.
There's the guy. Right?
Hey, we're going to give you an opportunity for a business thing after the show. Like, you won't believe it. It's going to be phenomenal. It's going to be the greatest thing that's ever happened.
Just manage your own money. Just stick it, stay. You got a long ways to go. Do you have an agent?
I have no one. That's just me.
That's all. Yeah,
you have to work on that.
Yeah, you do.
We got to get have someone.
What's
help
that
you
next right? step, Dennis? I mean, you
exactly that.
What's the next step for somebody like this?
You need someone to promote the work for you. You need a management person to boost you.
I tried. I had a manager for a while. It's just he wasn't doing what I needed him to do.
I got
when it comes
you.
To like my business. Yeah, or my career.
I know some people.
Talk
who
to some of your friends.
Talk
to somebody.
Know some people.
Well, no, I mean he's right because that industry is. You know, I know somebody who knows somebody, but you may want to go back to that person who paid you $5,000 at Summerfest. I mean, they know a lot of people too, and say, look, can you help me get to the next level?
I'm trying.
I want to hear your
show.
Stuff.
After the show, get a hold of me. I know some people that can give you open some doors for you.
Let's go ahead and do a song. We're going to do Hocus Pocus. Can you tell us about it real quick?
Oh, yeah. So so I'm an anime watcher. So, like, a lot of my songs not only come from, like, personal experience, but, like, sometimes I'll make up, like, these stories about anime characters because I also draw. So I made my own anime character's name's Chaos. So sometimes I'll make different stories so that... coexist with my heartbreak and my anime character and put it into a song. So Hocus Pocus Part 2 is about, you know, a guy that broke his girl's heart, but he's trying to get her back pretty much. He's going to get her back so fast, it'll be like magic. It'll be like Hocus Pocus.
I get it.
Much. Let's do it.
Oh, that's cool.
On Mino and the Mayor.
Baby, you my world and you know that. You tell me that you in love, you just gotta show that. you feel the heart, yeah. I ain't never been in love till you caught my eye, yeah. Kissing on your neck, rubbing on your thigh, yeah, yeah. Baby, you're the reason I'm even alive, yeah. I was a youngin' when I met you. I was in a dark place, but you came to my rescue. Baby, we got soul ties, your love is my refuge. Pray for your protection, I know God is gonna bless you, ay. I don't need no kisses, let me touch your mind. You were dying from a different world, call a Coraline. You was mine, you cannot deny, you a special find, yeah. Fighting through the dark, baby, yeah, come to the light, yeah. Baby, you my world and you know that. You tell me that you in love, you just gotta show that. You the one I got my eyes on, tell these girls that. I promise that I'ma ride for you. I know I did you dirty, I did you bogus. Hocus pocus, I won't go back to my own ways, now we broke. Young Sage, yeah. Baby, I know that I love that. I'ma make it right and you can trust that. Thinking about the way you say my name, you know I love that. I'm sorry for the arguments, but we gon' rise above that. Yeah. None of these girls could ever compare, you my main chick. You was rocking with me way before y'all ever made it. Let them haters hate on us, cause we not with that lame shit. Promise if you give me your heart, I'm never gon' break it.
Young Sage, Heights Pub and Parlor Music Series.
That's cool. That's
you know that. You tell me that you in love, you just gotta show that. You the one I got my eyes on. I promise that I'ma ride for you. I know I did you dirty, I did you bogus. Hocus pocus, I won't go back to my old ways. Now we broken. I messed up, but I gotta turn the page. I reminisce on dramatic days before I was Young Sage, yeah.
I can see the... Yeah, I bet you get a crowd that gets into this.
Actually, this is my biggest song right now.
Yeah,
Sony Records actually reached out to me and told me if I get this song to 1 million streams, I get a $2 million record deal. So this is the song that I'm trying to get to.
Let's work on it. Let's get it done.
We got to get that done.
It's at 270,000 streams right now.
And how many do you need?
One million.
Yep. So everybody can bring four friends, and we're there.
Pretty much.
We're going to set a quick break. Young Sage, Heights Pub and Parlor Music Series. Back with more. This is exciting stuff, buddy. Back after this.
You're listening to Civic Media. Find the latest news, information, and archives of all your favorite shows on the Civic Media website, civicmedia.us.
Trust nobody enough just to talk about your life when it gets tough. But I can see the pain in your eyes. I know that you're tired of the lies. This is my life, gonna live it the best way that I can. But you couldn't possibly understand the way I feel, yeah. I gave her my heart and my soul. She left me alone, got no control. Ain't no coming back, no, you're on your own. But I still miss my ringtone. Color my dreams, she gives me. I can't breathe, lost in her eyes. In my bed, we lay here, look at the sky. You're my drug, I take you, come and get high. All my love, she took it, I'm feeling numb. Love the way you taste it, you on my tongue. Lying awake, I miss you, what have I become? Because you flew away.
I think my I think my very favorite thing just happened.
I was just
going
to say. Go ahead.
Okay. So my very favorite thing just
happened. You caught Jim.
I looked up. Okay. And I saw Jim, and he was doing
bopping.
He was doing the white guy head bob. Okay.
It was great.
I saw you catch him because you started laughing.
Whoever mixes your music does a great job. That's
exactly.
Okay, so I actually want to give an opportunity to shout out. His name is Jimmy Wild. We don't do music together anymore. You know, he has his own stuff going on. But right. Jimmy is one of the most, like, crazy, like, music person. I don't even know what to call it. You would never even think he did music. Tall, lanky kid, looks like he just kicks it in the house and plays video games. When you see him, you're like, But this dude has such a gift for music, plays like 12 different instruments. Yeah. Like, most of the instruments you hear in my songs, he does himself.
It's you answered my question.
Dog, it's insane. We don't do. Yeah. I don't have a producer right now anymore. He had some, you know, mental stuff going on, whatever. But I need to shout him out because for 2.5-3 years we were grinding out music like crazy.
Yeah,
talented.
So I was, you know, these guys are laughing at me because I'm probably a little
bit more conservative.
I listen to barbershop music, but you know, this isn't really
he
the same as my dad.
Head bob going.
I was getting into it. You know,
that's the mayor's seal of approval right there.
I love that. That's the highest compliment possible.
Yeah, that's two so far. I'm feeling good right now.
This is Young Sage, Heights Pub and Parlor Music Series. Dennis, of course, from Glam Band, and Ashley from Heights Pub and Parlor.
Yes. So tomorrow the Badgers play. So stop in while the game is going on for happy hour pricing. The $4 rail mixers, $4 draft beers, and $3 bottle beers. And a huge reminder to mark your calendars for next Friday night, November 15th, as Michaela Lee will be playing live at Heights Pub and Parlor from 7 to 10. She was previously on Mino and the Mayor. Yep. And if you're looking to book a private event or party, our second floor and third story loft provides absolute best ambience for your private event, and dates are filling fast. So,
have you played there, Sage?
I don't know. What's the play called again?
Heights Pub and Parlor.
Right down the block.
Michaela Lee is our first one. Oh, so okay. This is.
There's a lot of restaurants who would just small venues. Yeah. You could probably be. I don't.
You'd love it.
He
there,
plays
though.
A little bit more You'd bigger than it. That, but. Yeah. really, you've got some great music. I'm happy for you. I'm a little. A couple of questions, but Oshkosh.
Ask whatever you like.
Well, I just think Oshkosh.
But Jim and I were talking during the break. But Chad Roy says this guy might be, really, really big.
I think you're on the cusp of that. I do. Tell me just a little bit for people who are listening, like your influences. You said your uncle was a big one, and
So when it comes to like music artists, a lot of my drive comes from two specific people: Juice WRLD. And Twista. I don't know, he's a little older. Mm-hmm. I studied Twista for like 12 years. That's how I learned how to speed rap. I don't know if you listen to any of my rap, but I rap really fast. And so like that's one thing that was also a niche for me. I finally met him for the first time. I did a performance for him. And I was the only one he came on stage to actually listen to. And he was standing next to me like this. And I'm like, bro, is that Twista? And I almost froze. I literally cried when I met him.
Oh, man.
He shook me up and everything, gave me his manager's number. He's like, we're going to be in touch. I'm like, that's insane.
Are you saying that he was doing the Jim Schmidt head bob? Yes,
he was doing the Jim Schmidt.
I was afraid Tom was going to say that, you know? All right.
Yeah, mostly them two, 100%.
Hard to believe Jim is white.
He's invited to the cookout. Don't worry.
Invited to the cookout.
Yeah,
he can
go.
That is classic.
So we got to push. We got to push a million plays for you. So
absolutely.
Again, let's review again. How do we get in touch with your music? How do the people?
So if you on Instagram, I try to keep up on my posts there. It's a YoungSage_official. Or Spotify is really, really big. That's what. And for any music artist listening, for anybody that is trying to push out their stuff, everyone looks for Spotify.
Okay.
Spotify is a very, very big thing. Of course, you can have your Apple Music. You have your YouTube. Pandora, stuff like that, but when they look at that Spotify, they want to see something.
We got to wrap it up.
Yeah, if we want to see you, that's the Facebook.
Young Sage. You look up Young Sage,
and you'll have where you're playing.
Facebook is Sage Mode, but anything else is Young Sage.
Can you get your music on the radio these days?
Oh yeah, that's the plan. I have like the ones you just heard. I have some radio ready songs. So anybody that wants to get me on the radio,
we got to push that too, man.
Yeah. Hocus Pocus Part 2.
Be fun watching you.
Your stuff is top flight, brother.
What do you bench?
The last time I benched was like three plates. That was about it, though. I couldn't do anything after that. After three plates, it's over with.
Three weights are not easy.
You know what's the real muscle guy when he talks plates? Yeah. None of your business, actually.
Oh, okay.
Wow.
Maybe you should ask the question.
Really?
You can't answer
Todd, it. Control your people, Todd. Hey, we are out of time. Young Sage, thank you so much. You're awesome. Dennis Glam Band.
Oh, yeah.
Keep it rocking. Ashley.
Woo, woo.
Okay. Have a great weekend, everybody. See ya.
The national news cycle never stops, but it can be hard to find news about your local community. Civic Media is dedicated to providing quality local and state news coverage across Wisconsin. With the Civic Media app, you can get notifications about local stories that matter to you and your community. Find the free Civic Media app in your phone's app store and choose notifications from the menu to tell us what kind of news you want to hear about.